Hello everyone, and I have these few more slides, and I will explain about some storage devices, some ports, and about audio, some audio discussion. So these are the one USB connections, and regardless of these are the 1.1 or 1.50, 2.0, 3.0, 3.1. So these are all USB connections, same look as you see that one. You see the types. Type B connector connects to a USB device such as a printer, and if you have a USB printer and you are aware of this, so how you connect your USB cable from type A to type B, B as in boy. The type A connector connects to USB port on the computer or on a hub, and you also should know and you might know about it. So you can have up to 127 devices you can chain with a single USB port. So, and typically USB is getting the market right now, especially with 3.0 and 3.1, and IEEE 1394, iLink or FireWire connections. So these connections are getting obsolete now, but few years back we had these connections very famous. You can support this connection can support up to 63 devices, but again mostly people are moving towards USB, and this is a small computer system interface, SCSI, SCSI connections, as you see on the back of the PC, used for networking, and you have 50 pins or 68 pins or 80 pins or different type of SCSI, narrow SCSI, wide SCSI, ultra wide SCSI 2, SCSI 3. So we have a separate topic about the SCSI in later videos, so we'll discuss about that one. But SCSI can hold multiple devices, and as I had this in my previous videos as well, and I will show you, I do have a narrow SCSI that supports 7 devices, including a host adapter, 8 devices. So, but I'm going to have that also. Is a PETA parallel ATA is a kind of IDE device. We used to call them IDE, integrated device electronics. Again, integrated device electronics, and you have a PETA cable. PETA cable could be 40 pins or could be 80 pins, double of that one if you have a blue controller, and PETA power cable, and you have this PETA ports. You have to count those pin 1 to 40 from left to right, and this is a Molex connector, M-O-L-E-X, Molex, that provides power to the device. And this is a SATA data cable, very common kind of cable or very common device what we use, and it is also replacing or taking over SCSI. So most likely we are using these days SATA connections, cheap storage, and a lot of companies are using. And these are the display cable and connector types of like a VGA, digital video input, VGA is a video graphic array, DVI, HD, HDMI, high definition multimedia interface, very famous, and where you have your audio and video into the same cable, so you can have a very nice and clean environment. Or mini HDMI you can use for your laptops, and super video is a kind of old, and the components, red, green, blue, also it is old, but still it is being used by a lot of people, but still it takes a lot of room, a lot of space from the back of your devices. Composite video and coaxial. Coaxial is getting obsolete, especially coaxial which goes to 185 meters, a thin net, and then you have a thick net. Those two are kind of obsolete now. And then you have a display ports, as we see that behind your PC, you can see that. And BNC also getting obsolete, is a British naval connector, is a round connector, looks like this one here. So that goes basically back of your coaxial cables, and we do not use mostly or most widely. And then you have this RCA jack. So I found this actually screen and researched, and I found this screen. I didn't have a back of my PC, so I had to post this picture here. And an RCA jack is a connector commonly used to connect various components in a audio video system. It is used for analog and coaxial digital audio and composite and component video connections. So it is a very commonly used, you might have on the back of your PC or back of your even TV. And audio video connections, they have a single core shielded cable or one pair shielded cable or three pin XLR connectors, which we have here. The most common connectors used in for unbalanced audio cables are 1/4 inch tip sleeve, like a TS or tip ring sleeve, TRS and RCA. So these are the very commonly used, you may or may not know about it. And the wireless device connections are Bluetooth, infrared and or radio frequencies. Very commonly used is a Bluetooth right now. So infrared, like you have some kind of a line of sight connection from your device, for example your mouse to your TV, it has to be a line of sight, so you have to have in front of each other, so it has a sensor which detects basically the signal, and have a radio frequency very commonly used and kind of old now. So I will continue with my videos here, and keep watching my videos, and I will see you in my next video. Thank you.